Hey everybody, this is Harold taking the Matilda out for a spin today, my premium medium Russian tank. The tiers on this map range from 5 to 3, being tier 5, I'm near the top. So I think what I'll do is I'll head into the city. I've spawned close to the city, so I think I'll just head that way because I am not that fast. This tank, I think, I'm not the authority, but I think this tank packs good armor and a good punch, but not necessarily good speed. So I'm going to head in, see what we can see. I guess that's a phone booth, right? I just hang out right here, whether that would be useful. I'm still learning the various maps, so I don't have all the optimal spots, but I can kind of look down both ways here. Is there somebody over there? There is.
That's gotta hurt.
So I'll just shoot over my shoulder. Is there a heavy tank down there? I see an icon. I'll still say it, look this way.
We nailed him back.
So they're beginning to shoot at me because the guys in front are taking cover. Gotta wait for this guy to poke his nose out. There's that heavy tank. He can't see me, which is probably good for me. Is everybody over there dead? Looks like maybe they're either dead or retreated. So I think I'll push up this way because it looks like we don't have much in the way of assets this way. See what I can find. Ah, there's a tank destroyer.
We nailed it back!
I'm going to fall back because I see more people coming. Little bit. No? I thought so. Maybe I'll go up behind this heavy tank, actually. Looks like they fell back.
Enemy is hit! Ammo hit! We're lucky it didn't blow!
Ah! I wanted to finish off that heavy tank that's retreating at 4%. I thought the other guys on the right side of the road pulled back further. I wonder if I could swing out wide and get a shot this way.
That one didn't go through.
Yeah, he's got his frontal armor towards me, and I can't penetrate that, even if he is at 4%. So it looks like there's another one of our heavies moving up to finish the job. Yep, there he goes. So I still have plenty of ammo. I'll move up to support this heavy. I don't see anybody down there, so I'll move up further. Catch these guys in a little bit of a pinch. Nice, nice. That was well executed. I went for the light tank because I figured I could pen him easier.
They're hit.
Don't shoot me. That's funny. It looks like, well, this is a victory. Oh, that was the last guy. It shows you how much I'm paying attention. Not too shabby, huh? So did I blow up? And I don't think I killed anybody, but I, as you can see, I got tangled up with quite a few enemy tanks. Oh, and they changed how this goes. Damage by... So they changed how this is. I did kill... Looks like they flipped it around. So I spotted one. And here's, I guess, allied damage to somebody I spotted. And then I ended up damaging these guys and killing that one tank. So not too shabby. Especially with the premium tank. And I get a double bonus because I think this was my first... first victory of the day with this tank. So not too shabby at all. Thank you very much for watching. Hey everybody, this is Hale doing some World of Tanks, taking the Hetzer out for a spin today. So this is a standard map, tiers 4 through 2. Looks like just artillery is 2 on our side, the other side goes down to tier 3. So I'll be near the top. This is a standard battle. And I'm just going to head towards the enemy objective and see what I can see. I might stay up here on this hill. So my elevation kind of tops out here. Actually, I think I'll just back up. And kind of stay up here and see if I can get some long-range shots in. Can't see that guy, can't see that guy. Now I can see him.
We've hit them hard.
Yeah, joys of being in a tank destroyer, I had to move the vehicle, which ruined my aim. So I think I'll just stay up here. This is a very nice hill. I got good cover. Here's somebody over there. And again, they're behind the hill. So if they come down this way, I should be able to see them. Oh, look at that shot. Look at that shot. Very nice. I do say so myself. And can I see that guy? I think I can. And can I see that guy?
He's gone. Find another target.
I got him even though I lost visual. I'm going to move since I've attracted some attention. So I'm going to move over to... There is Artie on this map. The other team only has one. Oh, there's a guy right here. I didn't even see him. I can see that guy. I hope I don't hit that friendly right next to him. Got him across the map. Look at that. This is what side strafe does, sniping while everybody else gets shot at. I had this guy for a second. There's somebody, a bunch over here. Oops. Yeah, ping the map. So I can't see them at all. Let's see if I can see this one person. There's an Artie over there.
Enemy armor is damaged.
Alright, their artillery is down. Should probably move here to help defend. See anybody. That tank looks like we lost a tank destroyer over there. So I'm just going to stay here and wait for them to come over the hill. Meantime, can I see that guy? No, he's behind the hill. The Artie looks like it's moving up to engage, which is a bad idea. See that guy. now you're dead. So who's over here behind me? Okay, there we go. Push that tree over because I can. There's only one guy left, so we're going to call this one a victory. Not too shabby. 4 kills on the day. A lot of snipage. I can't see that guy. Can't see that guy anywhere. But not too shabby with the Hetzer, huh? Oh, we just lost somebody. And that guy's down, so that's going to be a win for the good guys. And not too bad a haul, especially with the first win of the day experience boost. So you can see they reversed their layout, so end up killing 4 vehicles and hitting, 6? So not too bad. Anyway, this has been Hale with Z Hetzer, and the map was Highway, I forgot to mention that. Hope you enjoyed it. Thank you very much. Hey everybody, welcome back to the World of Tanks. I am in my T-57 right now, American Tier 2 Artillery. You don't see a lot of artillery on YouTube videos, or at least I don't see it on, I guess, side strafes for the most part, but doesn't seem to be a lot of videos of it, and it is a unique player experience, so I wanted to do it a little bit. This is the Provence map, probably French. So this map, there's like 2 cliffs and the flags are in the middle. We go up the cliff on this side and then the other guys go on the cliff on the other side. And basically you shoot each other through the 2 cliffs, and then if you go in the middle, it's like a death trap. So I'm gonna try and find some place relatively not obvious that I won't get killed from. I'm thinking back here is good. So there's nothing in my way because artillery uses a ballistic trajectory. So I don't want to have anything too high in front of me, but I can shoot over the relatively low stuff. So this looks pretty good for where I'll be shooting. So let's go into artillery mode. This is what you don't see. It's a top-down view. There you go. So the circle is my area of hit, and then the longer you leave it still, the more accurate you get. So basically, you just kind of put it where you think it'll be. There's probably guys in here. Well, here's a guy over here. Where you think it'll be, and then put it round out there. That's as close as I can get to it with the house there. Oh, there's somebody up here. All right, good. This guy should die. Got him, and now he's dead. So we each have 2 artillery pieces on each side. I've seen games with up to 4. Typically, it's between 0 and 4 pieces of artillery in a game. So you have to really tailor your play style based upon how much artillery is there. So there's guys that are pushed up all the way. Very, very nice job doing it without dying. So there should be some people up here I just can't see. So this unit is an elite artillery unit. I can't... Oh, I can shoot that far. Around there. This guy's behind the house now. So the house is blocking my trajectory, so I can't hit him without hitting the house. Oh, there's a bunch of guys down here, so let's take care of business here. Because these guys could theoretically come over and kill me, and we don't want that to happen. This guy's 1%. He's a 1%er. I give up on that guy. I can't see him anymore. Kill this guy and then I'll look
enemy
at me. There you go. That's that 1% guy. So we got a light tank down there. I can't shoot these people, so I'm just going to go up here.
Enemy is
hit. So sometimes you get lucky with like the area, like your accuracy, if you know what I mean. and sometimes you don't. So a moving target is much harder to hit with artillery, in part because they're moving, and in part because when you move your gun, it becomes less accurate. Put a shot in this bush. So we're down two players, two tanks. There's a guy. Right there in that tree. Can I get their artillery? That is in range. Let's try for a lucky shot. No. Let's see if we can get him over on this side. So that, you know, you just fire. See if you can hit anybody. So we really need some... here's some targets. So let's see if we can get them going around here. So they should be coming down this road, I'm guessing. So we have absolutely no scouting. So here's somebody. Now I'm not in a good position where I'm at right here to get these guys. I'm actually going to shoot at these guys first. The challenge is with artillery is, you know, you can shoot all over the map, but you need scouting to see anybody, and you need stationary targets. Now you can also use artillery kind of as a tank destroyer, a bad tank destroyer. Alright, so it's a light tank, which is over here. Can I get this guy? Oh good, he's dead. Alright, so let's go out of artillery mode, and let's see if we can do some direct fire. So you can see it looks like your traditional tank destroyer thing. Except you can't zoom in the way a tank destroyer would. In fact, I'm going to go back to artillery. This guy's going to sacrifice himself. I'm taking fire up here. Oh, that's it. Not a good game as artillery. But anyway, I think that gives you an idea as to how artillery plays. I'll probably just keep this. So we lost with a base cap. But it's kind of neat. Got one kill. So let's see how we did. You know, not spectacularly. So we killed one person. Did some damage. Did good damage to this guy. So everybody we engaged, you know, basically died. And then I got blown up by this guy. Another T-57. So what happened was I got lit by the other tanks, and then their artillery got me. So that's a danger with artillery as well. But when you're down to just two or three guys left, what are you going to do? Anyway, this has been Hale doing some... what is this? World of Tanks. That is what it is. And, one other thing while we're here. This is a new tank, T-28. This is a successor for the T-46 light tank. This is a medium tank. This tank is bad. It's a bad tank. Let's see if we can go into... Look at the armor. So the turret has 20-20-20. The hull is 30-20-20. This is really, really thin for a medium tank. Let's look at this one. It's 22-15-15. So if you look, the front armor is actually, it has better turret armor, and the hull armor is not as good, but you know, it's pretty darn close. Now this tank is very, very fast. It's a fast tank. The guns though you get on it aren't that great. Looking at the tech tree, I didn't want to do that. Let's go back. Let's go to research. That'll take me where I want to be. So you get the 76mm gun, which is basically the derp gun from the T-46, and I've gotten the best one you can get for this one. It's a little bit better than the other ones. You can get a 57mm, which looks to be pretty good. But to be honest, I really don't want to spend a lot of money on this tank or a lot of credits, research, really. The credits are actually fairly easy to come by, at least at this level. The research you kind of have to grind for. So I don't want to put a lot in here. I'm going for the KV-1, which is very popular. This is a heavy tank. So that is what I'm shooting for. And I'm trying not to use common experience. I have, for this tank, 9,478, as you can see right here. I have 8,000 in common experience. And you get a trickle. As far as normal gameplay, you can use gold to convert experience, vehicle-specific experience, to common experience. But that costs real money. So you get a trickle up here. So I'm going to save this for when I really need it. So I'm just kind of playing this one a couple times a day to advance it up. On the other front, I have almost got enough research here to unlock the Stug, which is the next higher tank destroyer. Then this will become an elite vehicle. As you can see, these are, like, that's an elite vehicle. This one is not. So most of the ones, the Stuart, the Artillery, the Panzer 38, the T-46, and the Matilda came as an elite vehicle, are elite. The Hetzer is not because I need to unlock the Stug, and then the T-28 is not because I just got it, basically. So I'm not going to make this elite. I'm just going to go right through it and get the follow-on vehicle. So also, I've been trying to level up my guys. I don't have anybody at 100%, and then you can start to unlock perks and stuff like that. So I think the highest level I got are 90s right here in this vehicle right here. I really like this P-38 Tier 4 tank. It's very nice. Has good. The way I have it configured, you can either have it really good speed, or you can have it decent speed and good damage, I think. So I have it configured for decent speed, good damage. I have a heavy gun on it. I think this is a 50 millimeter, yeah, 5 centimeter on here. It's really nice. And if you look at the armor, on this, oh, it shows it on this screen. The front armor on here is 50-50. You compare that to the Russian medium tank, and it just blows it away. It's ridiculous. So 50-50. So this is actually better armored than the Tier 4 Russian medium tank. Granted, this is a Tier 4 tank as well, so you'll have that. But the gun's more accurate. I think it has... Does it have greater penetration? Let's see. Let's see. So 67, 130, 25... 67, so it's close. It's close. This one actually does better penetration. I have to remember what all these numbers mean in the slashes. But it's not significantly different. So I like this tank. I like this tank. There's a lot of popular German tanks, and this might, or light tanks around this tier level. And this might not be the best one, but I like it. And then I like my Hetzer too. So I'm probably going to keep this. You see a lot of Hetzers, and they have really nice armor, 60 front armor. Now I think it's vulnerable down here and on the gun and probably this viewport right here, but it does take a beating under certain circumstances. Anyway, that's kind of updates as far as my account goes. Thank you for watching.